Hello everyone, again, Frank DiMora here from the Last Chronicles of Planet Earth, the book that I wrote, the documentary, which you can get for free going to my website, www.endtimesresearchministry.com. And I wanted to bring to focus one of the promises of the Old Testament that had to do with Israel in our generation that has been pinpointed as the one that will see the return of the Lord Jesus Christ. And if there's any way to see the fulfillment of our Lord's words coming to pass, and it's right in our face, this is the best way for me to do it. And I want to show you the promise of God in Deuteronomy chapter 33, verse 19 first. Then I'm going to show you how it is coming to pass. Now keep in mind, what I'm about to show you is just a little tip of the iceberg of what's happened since I've been monitoring how Israel has found oil and gas. Look at Deuteronomy 33. They shall call the people into the mountain, there they shall offer sacrifices of righteousness, and they shall suck of the abundance of the seas and of the treasures hidden in the sand. So God warned us many, many, many years before that they were going to find oil and gas. The Israelis finding gas in the water, the oceans, and also in their own sand. And they have discovered that. Now, in a very short period of time where Israel went with virtually having almost no oil and depending on many of the world's countries that have an abundance of oil, they have gone from having none of that oil or gas to being oil exporters in a very short period of time. And it only happened after Israel became a nation again, which was another fulfillment of Bible prophecy that you'll find in Ezekiel chapter 37. Look at the headline today from the News. Israel, Jordan signed $15 billion natural gas deal. Israel to supply Jordan with natural gas from its vast Leviathan offshore gas fields over a period of 15 years, U.S. giant Noble Energy announced Wednesday. A source close to the deal said it was worth $15 billion, 11.4 billion euros, a significant chunk of some 60 billion, which Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has said will come from Israel's offshore gas exports. Noble announced in a statement the execution of a non-binding letter of intent to supply natural gas from the Leviathan field offshore Israel to the National Electric Power Company, of course, you'll see, of Jordan. And we're talking not billions. Look at this. Trillion cubic feet. Look. Noble Energy and the Leviathan partners will supply a base gross quantity of 1.6 trillion cubic feet of natural gas from the Leviathan field over a 15-year term, it said. God's word has come to pass. And my friends, please listen to what I'm telling you. Israel has not come to an end of finding other fields of gas and oil. God is blessing Israel, and it's very, very specific prophecy for the last days. Israel is now exporting the gas, changing the dynamics in the Middle East, the energy dynamics, if you will, disrupting much of what I believe would be, for example, Iraq, it would be Iran, it would be these other Middle East Islamic nations who do not like to see, including Russia, who is an oil giant, they don't want to see Israel with all this black gold, if you will. And so it is changing the dynamics in the Middle East. And I believe that it's going to be in part why Russia and the Islamic nations will go down after Israel's spoils, as we see in the Ezekiel war, which is found in Ezekiel 38 and 39. Now, moving on to another prophecy. I want to show you, yesterday I talked about the Psalm 83 war, and I know that I have new people coming to my site all the time. And for the purpose of understanding what's going on and my warning that I gave 2 weeks ago, I want to bring to fruition something that I showed you 2 weeks ago along with my assistant Amy Naomi when I was giving my seminar, and she posted some of this information for me. In the Ezekiel 38 war, we see Russia along with the Islamic nations. They are the nations who do not border Israel. However, that war from Ezekiel will take place after the Psalm 83 war. And the Psalm 83 war, those nations border the nation of Israel. And in this photo you see, from 1 to 10. On the left-hand side, you'll see the nations from the Old Testament that are going to attack Israel, and I believe it's coming up very, very soon. And so you'll see Jordan, you'll see that it's the Saudis, the Palestinians, the Egyptians, Hezbollah. You're going to see Syria, Iraq, the Lebanon, and of course the Phoenicia, which is the modern day Palestinians. Now let me show you what I warned you. This is coming from my site. I gave you some warnings about ISIS and what the goal of ISIS is. And for that, let me just go over to my site to show you what I said. So we're at my prophecy site now, and if you just found my YouTube channel, this is what my prophecy site looks like. I'll leave you the address to get there. But when you scroll down, you're going to be able to tap into my book for free, and there's the link right there. You just click on that link, and of course, when you get to the newest page, you're going to see the September 2nd, 2014 edition of my book. Now, this is the warning that I gave on that post a few weeks ago. You'll see the target of Israel. How many of you believe ISIS' main target is Syria? Assyria is one of the nations that is mentioned in the Psalm 83 war against Israel. ISIS has said that after Syria, they will turn their attention to Israel. You will see why I said this as you keep reading below. And of course, we gave you some information about the nations surrounding the nation of Israel, and they are enemies of Israel. They've been making plans. You've been watching the war in the Gaza Strip, which is Hamas, the Hezbollah, the Phoenicia of the Old Testament, right? So let me bring you to two articles that I posted a few weeks ago showing you that the sphere of the ISIS group, this terrorist group, is moving in with the Palestinians, the Phoenicians, who are going to play a major role in the Psalm 83 war as all of these nations come together as a confederacy, as it says in Psalm 83, verse 5. Now, take a look at this. This is an article that I put up June 29th, 2014. ISIS now openly operating in Gaza, flag seen waving at funeral. It says mourners in Gaza were seen carrying black flags of the bloody Islamic State in Iraq and Syria, ISIS terror group, at a funeral on Sunday for one of the two terrorists Israel targeted in an airstrike on Friday. Now moving down, it says analysts said that this was the first such open sign of local support for the group also known as the Islamic State in Iraq and the Levant, which is engaged in a fierce battles for the control of Iraq and Syria in order to create a unified Islamic caliphate. So that unified caliphate that they're talking about, Islamic caliphate, we see all of the nations infiltrating. So ISIS going into each one of these nations, and we can see the hatred of ISIS on Israel, and they want to destroy Israel, just like we see in the Psalm 83. Israel and other Western intelligence services have warned that the group's influence is spreading and may set down roots in the coastal enclave, which they've already done. We know that for sure. And of course, the instigation, as you can see, continued on back then, and the rockets, says on Saturday night, six rockets fired from Gaza struck Israel, with two hitting a popular building. Now let me move on to another one of the warnings 2 weeks ago showing that ISIS is moving in to really close area, approximately, to Israel in the Gaza Strip, as we see in, guess what? Psalm 83, which I'll keep going back to. Now, the second warning that we posted, and we did post more than that, but I'm just giving you two from, this one is from July 15, 2014. The extremist terror organization is establishing a foothold inside Gaza, despite Hamas claims to the contrary. 2+ weeks into the Gaza's current battle with Israel, ceasefire negotiations are stalled. The Israeli forces are mobilizing for potential ground invasions from the north and east, and the Egyptian government to the south is indifferent. Gazans are finding themselves increasingly isolated. And of course, we do know that Israel went in to the Gaza Strip. Everybody watched that. The fighting went on for more than a month. And by the way, as long as I'm here, when it's talking about Israel being isolated, Zechariah 12:3, another prophecy about the last days, shows us that Israel will be alone in the last days. So we read continuously about information that Israel's being isolated. It's just prophecy coming to pass. But most people who don't know the word of the Lord wouldn't know that and wouldn't be able to make the connection. Now moving on. But not, it seems, alone. And I'm going to start right here. It says, it suggests that the Islamic Sunni organization, which has taken over roughly half of Iraq and threatens Assad in Syria, has ties with militant groups operating in Gaza. Can you see what I'm showing here? They're all one. Even though that the Syrians are fighting these militant groups or trying to depose Bashar al-Assad's government, they're all one. They're one entity. And the day is coming when this entire entity is going to change direction, make an attempt to go into Israel. Moving on, while Hamas has dominated Gaza since 2005, dozens of rival Islamic factions operate in the Strip. And I've been warning about this for a very long time. Over the past few weeks, two Salafist groups have pledged alliance to ISIS and claimed responsibility for the rocket fire into Israel. Go figure. I've been warning about this, and I'm praying that people will start paying attention because we're getting very, very close to that war. And when that war is finished, I know that a lot of people are going to see what I've been trying to show them, and that is the fulfillment of prophecy, and they'll embrace our Lord Jesus Christ. There will be many who will come to know the Lord because what's going on. Now, I'm going to bring you up to date because this information just came out. As you see, September the 4th, 2014, I showed you what I warned. I showed you the parameters of what the goals of ISIS were. I've been sharing with that, what that goal was. For many, many months now, look with the news. ISIS intends to take control of Palestine. Well, the influence of ISIS was in Palestine 2 weeks ago, they were showing you. And believe me, people, it was there a long time ago. It may have been sleeping, but it was there being established because they have a goal, and their goal is to try to take out Israel. The intent of ISIS radical group is to take control of Palestine. And of course, when they're talking about Palestine, they're not just talking about the Gaza Strip. They're talking about Israel. And what they're showing us here is the very essence of prophecy from the Psalm 83 war, where in verse 5, it said they're coming together. They've come together, obviously, to make a plan, and they're going to be carrying that plan out. According to the article, this is supported by media reports that ISIS cells are forming inside the Gaza Strip. Moreover, this intent to murder Jews was advertised last month when hooded ISIS members chanted death to Jews at a protest in the Netherlands. Now, in capping this off, this is news from today, September the 5th, 2014, the Times of Israel. Palestinians said heading to Syria, Iraq to join Islamic State. Are my warnings coming to fruition? You better believe it. And the reason why they are coming to fruition, because I'm looking at what our Lord has said in the Bible, the written word, the truth. And I know that it is truth. And I know that because it is truth, these things have to come to pass. That's why ISIS has made dramatic moves into Iraq, in Syria, into Lebanon, into Sinai, and now into the Palestinian area of the Gaza Strip. They're coming together, the Salafit, to destroy the nation of Israel. It says West Bank and Gaza residents, among other foreigners seeking to fight alongside jihadists, group intelligence sources say. Palestinians from the Gaza Strip and the West Bank have joined the ranks of the Islamic State group, Channel 2 reported Thursday, citing intelligence sources. The report came a day after Defense Minister Moshe Yeldon formally designated the organization as a terror group along with Al-Qaeda-affiliated Abdul Ziyam Brigades. That move enables Israel to act against the organizations by prohibiting gathering, recruitment, fundraising, and other activities, Israel Radio reported. The step was taken upon the recommendation of Shin Bet, possibly to grant the organization legal tools to deal with the Palestinian jihadists who might return from fighting in the group's ranks in Syria and Iraq. So they're worried about the people in the Gaza Strip joining forces to get rid of Bashar al-Assad and then turning back to Israel to try to get rid of the Jews. And of course, Bashar al-Assad, as I mentioned yesterday, stated that if his government was going to fall, that he would attack Israel. So either way, we see the Syrians, we see the Islamists from ISIS, the Palestinians coming against Israel. Now look at this. On Wednesday night, Israel's Channel 10 aired footage of what is said was an Islamic State rally on the Temple Mount. The report, which is to be broadcast in full next week, said the gathering underlined that the Islamic State intends to focus on Israel in the future, and this is exactly what I said was going to happen. And it is based on the word of the Lord, and you will be there to see it. Now, here is another important piece to this article right here that I want to share with you. Speakers were filmed declaring their anticipation of liberation of Jerusalem and decrying Jewish pollution of the city. Several black IS flags were seen in the footage. Now, I've been blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ to be able to connect the dots between His word and reality, in other words, it coming to pass. I wish that I could actually make you receive Jesus Christ, but I can't do that. I know that I can't do that. That's up to the Lord Jesus Christ to touch the hearts. My job is to give you the word of the Lord and the information connecting those dots that you can see the reality of our Lord's words coming true. And if you see all of these things that are coming to pass, you saw the oil and the gas, and if you've been watching my videos, you've seen all the rest of the prophecies that are coming to pass that I'm showing you. But as we focus now in on Israel, in ISIS, and what's going on in the Middle East, it is coming to war, a full-blown war again in the Middle East, and Israel will win. ISIS thinks that they are a powerful organization. ISIS has billions of dollars now being poured in, and they're spending it on the goal of the destruction of the nation of Israel. And ISIS will continue to move in every one of these nations until they turn their attention on Israel. And when that happens, all the people that are worried about ISIS are going to see firsthand how God is going to sanctify His holy name. And the enemy that tries to wipe out the nation of Israel, as we see in Psalm 83:4, ISIS will be destroyed. This is Frank DiMora saying, please watch the news and trust in Jesus Christ. And above all, because we're closing in on our second coming of the Lord Jesus Christ, accept Jesus as your personal Savior while there's still time left. Now, I did mention a couple days ago that there was a lot of news coming down the pike, and it's coming faster than I've ever seen it before. And for many people, it's too much to take. And for many people, they will read a little bit of the information and throw away the rest of the information because it's overload. Some people just can't handle what's going on around the world. I can understand that. But for us who love the Lord Jesus, He gives us this inner strength, even in the mix of all the hatred and the brutality that we see happening around the world and natural disasters and whatnot. The Lord gives us this inner peace. Now, my assistant, Amy Naomi, she puts a lot of the news together for me. Fantastic researcher. And she has something to say that may help a lot of you who are having problems reading the news and comprehending everything that's going on. So Amy has made a tape for me. I'm going to play what she had to say.
Hi, my name is Amy. I'm Frank DiMora's assistant. I'm sure that you guys have heard of me at least occasionally. I want to start off by apologizing. I am not a public speaker. As a matter of fact, being in front of a group of people terrifies me. But I've been led by the Lord to give you a message today, and it's based on some personal experience. While working with Frank, I've noticed that a lot of you are anxiety-ridden over the amount of news that we've seen lately, because the birth pains have increased. And I know that Frank sent out a message back in July that talked about how important it was to be in prayer and, you know, maybe take a step back, take a few days off, and that the news would still be there. For some reason, and I don't know why, and I don't know how many people this is going to help, but I feel it necessary to share my personal story with you for some reason. And hopefully it will help some of you out there. It's been about going on 7 years since I found Frank DiMora. And at first I wasn't his assistant. The way that came to be is after church one Sunday, I decided that I wanted to give one day a week to the Lord, and I committed to Him one full day a week. All I was going to do, I wouldn't work, I wouldn't take care of the housework, I wouldn't do anything except study His Word. And when it started very slow. I would read a Bible verse here and there and really delve into it, what it meant. A couple of weeks went by, and I was looking for a study to do. And I picked up a book off my bookshelf that I hadn't cracked open about studying the end times for yourself. Well, the first thing I did was lift my head up and I said, "You've got to be kidding me." 7 years ago, I didn't want to know about the end times. My philosophy had always been, when the Lord splits the sky, then I get to go home, and that's all I really need to know. When I cracked open this book, I only made it through the first two pages. I just couldn't deal with it. The next day, a friend of mine gave me information on Frank's website. So I went there, and I started looking around, and it was overwhelming. And I downloaded his book, and I printed it all by myself, and I started to tear it apart. Every little thing that he had put in his book as fact, I wanted to double check and make sure it was right and accurate and see what I could find. And during this process, there's nothing like being fed on the Word of God. I was overwhelmed. I cried and I cried, and I would walk away and I would wave papers in the air, and I would tell my husband, "You have to look at this, you have to look at this." And my husband would look at me and he would say, "Oh, well, there's always been famine in Africa, and there's always been drought all over the world, and there's always been earthquakes." And he didn't buy it. And I just kept studying and studying and studying, and I got all the way through Frank's book. And something was born in me, just a desire to obey the Lord and everything He said, no matter how difficult that was for me. And one of the main principles, I guess, that I learned is Jesus told us over 22 times in the Bible to watch these events. And I'm here to tell you, I'm just like you guys. I get overwhelmed. I get tired. By the end of the day, after working with Frank, my fingers are falling off. My eyeballs feel like they're bleeding. I'm sick to my stomach from some of the things that I see. It's horrendous. And it does get overwhelming. What I can tell you is, 7 years later, my husband now can preach this almost better than I can. And on a day-to-day basis, I'm okay. The Lord gives peace to these things. And I can honestly tell you, although I don't know how. Every time I see more and more bad news, it makes me happy. Now, people think I'm crazy when I say that, but it is the truth. Because every bad thing that happens means that we are closer to going home. And I don't know about you, but I'm tired of this. We all are. And if the Lord says that this is what has to happen for us to go home, then I am more than happy to see it come to pass. Doesn't make it easy. He never said that it would be easy. But I want to share something with you that I've learned from my personal experience. He truly will equip you. One thing I do to keep myself energized on this, and that I've learned, is that the Lord loves nothing more than when we throw His words back at Him. Now, I know that sounds crazy, but when you go to the Lord in prayer, and you have read a section of the Bible, and you get on your knees and you say to Him, Lord, Your word promises me this, there's nothing that He loves more. So what I want to share with you today is Psalm 91:4. He shall cover thee with His feathers, and under His wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Under His wings you find shelter. And if you look up the word wings and what that means in the original Hebrew, it is the word kanaf, the corner of a garment. I know a lot of people wonder why the Jews wear the prayer shawls around them, and it's based on this. Those are the wings. When I took this verse literally and I sought refuge under His wings because I was looking for peace, I did something really silly because, you know, I'm not a rabbi. I took a very soft blanket and I put it in the dryer just for a minute until it was warm and soft. I took my blanket into my closet, because the Lord tells you to have your little prayer closet. And I put that blanket over my head. And I recited Psalm 91:4 to Him over and over. And I said, You've promised me that You will give me peace under Your wings. And I need it. And do you know what? He did. All the anxiety that I feel on a daily basis from seeing the things that I do. And believe me, Frank and I suffer the same things that you guys do. We get overwhelmed by this. But every day when I crawl into my closet and put that blanket over my head and I stand on His promise alone, I feel reborn and renewed and peaceful. I sleep hard at night, I'll tell you that, because it's exhausting to do all of this. But there's a peace about it. And I start my day the same way. Just wanting to be led by Him and used by Him in everything that I do. And because of those two things, I have come to this point. So when you see the amount of things going on in the world, I just want to encourage you to go somewhere quiet and stand on His promise that He will give you peace. Trust it. Beat your mind into submission. That's all I can say. And we are distracted in the middle of a prayer. You know, 10,000 things happen. People knock on the door. You know, your mind wanders away. Just keep repeating His word over and over until your mind submits to it. And at that point, you will feel peace. I know it's hard, but I do want to encourage you all to try to find some joy in the things that we're seeing. Because as difficult as it is, it does mean that very soon, we are going to have our new bodies and look upon the face of our Lord Jesus. And in the end, I believe that that's all any of us want. We want to go home. I don't know why the Lord compelled me to say these things, but I hope that in some small way it helps one person, and that's all we can ask. And I pray His peace upon each of you that hear this, each of you that look at the amount of news on Frank's site every day. I will keep all of you in my prayers, and I just ask that the Lord give each of you peace in your heart and joy to know that very soon we will be with Him and we will never, ever have to see these things ever again. God bless you all.